Good morning to all of you. Good morning, I am Professor Utkarsh Nigam from the Department of Civil Engineering, LD College of Engineering, Ahmedabad. I hope you all are doing well at your place and you are fit and healthy over there. Today, we shall discuss about the module number 2, that is fuzzy logic and its aspects and its application in the civil engineering as well. We have already discussed about the introduction to the soft computing techniques in the module number 1. We have also discussed about the difference between the hard computing techniques and the soft computing techniques. What is the difference between both of them that we have discussed in the earlier in the module number 1? Today we are going to discuss the first software computing technique, that is the fuzzy logic. We will try to understand about the fuzzy logic. What do we mean by the fuzzy? For example, if we are having, I am just giving a small example and then we will proceed with the PowerPoint presentation as well. So for example, you have heard the term rigid and flexible. You have also heard about the binary system, that is 0 or 1. For example, what do we understand by the flexible? Flexible means something in which we are having the authority or we are having the flexibility to do something. That is actually known as what we can say is the flexibility. Rigidness means yes, we have only one answer, that is yes or no. For example, in this pandemic situation, we have to go outside or we have not to go outside. So we are having the answers as yes or no. The situations in which we are having, the answer is yes or no. Nothing else or no explanation of it. That is known as the rigid system. That is known as the Boolean logic or crisp logic. That is the thing that we need to understand. Fuzzy means something that is having some flexibility, which is something beyond yes and no, in between yes and no with some explanations. So in the today's lecture, we are going to understand about that flexibility aspects. For example, if someone is having his age as 35, so 35 if is the age of a person, we can call him as a young, or we can call him as an experienced, or we can call him as a little older. So in which range we are going to put him? Or is he young or not? So as per CRISP, he is young or he is what we can say as old. But if fuzzy logic or flexibility is persistence, then we can call him as a experienced, or we can call him as a young, or we may also call him as an older person. So that is actually the beauty of fuzzy logic, that even in the data sets, even in the larger data sets, in the missing data sets also, it gives the flexibility to the answers. So we are going to discuss the fuzzy logic in detail, and in the subsequent video with the PowerPoint presentation, you will be able to understand fuzzy logic very well. So this is the first soft computing technique that we will discuss, and hope you will pay attention to it. We will try to understand each and every aspect of fuzzy logic and its application. It will be very easy, and the video is very informative. So you can watch this video, and a few slides have been made by me, a few photographs have been made by me, and some images have been taken from the internet. So the quality of the images is internet also. So thank you very much, and now we will proceed this lecture through the PowerPoint presentation. Thank you very much.
Now we will continue this lecture with the help of this PowerPoint presentation and try to understand the concepts of fuzzy logic and its applications. So this is in this subject soft computing techniques, we are going to study one soft computing technique which is known as fuzzy logic and its applications. So these are the content about which we will try to learn, that what do we understand by fuzzy logic, the introduction to it, the fuzzy sets and membership functions, what are the different operations that can be done on the fuzzy sets or mathematical CRISP sets, and how it differs from the fuzzy sets, the relations, the fuzzy rules, propositions, implications and inferences, the defuzzification techniques, some applications of fuzzy logic in the field of civil engineering. So we are going to have a look on all these content in this presentation. This is actually the syllabus of GTU which is being offered in the PDDC semester 5. So we actually have undergone in detail in the last video, in the previous video itself. So we are going to directly switching towards the module number 2 which is fuzzy logic, one of the soft computing technique that we are going to discuss. So in this particular domain, in this particular chapter, we are going to understand, and we will try to develop this course outcome that you will develop the fuzzy logic sets and membership functions, and will understand about the defuzzification techniques, and will be able to demonstrate it as well. So these are the content that we have discussed earlier as well, that apart from the introduction and methodology of the fuzzy logic, we are going to discuss the different operations, the fuzzy sets, membership functions, different rule formations, etc. over it. Also, we will try to study and discuss with the help of the screenshots, that how this fuzzy logic can be built in a MATLAB, how a model of fuzzy logic can be built. So first of all, try to understand fuzzy logic. Fuzzy means some flexibility is there, some fuzziness is there, means there is something which is having a particular logic and which is not fixed, which is not rigid. So that is what we understand by fuzzy. And fuzzy logic means anything which we want to do is not crisp or rigid in the nature. Means whatever we are going to apply will have the possibility of every possible circumstances as well. So for example, there is a car ahead of another car or ahead of your car, and how much it is distant from that particular car. So if it is at a particular distance and the distance is more, then easily brakes can be applied and the time taken in the brakes can be increased. However, if the distance is comparatively small, then the brakes will have to be applied very quickly. So this is one of the day-to-day example by which we can understand the application of brakes. If the car which is going ahead of us is very much distant from us, then we can apply the brakes very flexibly, very slowly. But if the car is very much close to our car or very much close to our bike, then at that time we have to apply the brakes comparatively faster. So that is the difference, means one type of automatic braking system or one type of braking system when a human is applying over it. So if car is close, then yes or no, instantly you have to take the decision. But if the car is distant, so that you can apply the brakes slowly. So whenever you can answer any question with the explanation, it may be yes, it may be no, there may be explanation, or it may be between yes or no. So that is actually the application of fuzzy logic is there. So fuzzy logic is actually algorithm which is used to solve models which are basically on the logical reasoning, like imprecise and vague. Means you are not having a precise information, not accurate information, but yes, of course you have some information and you want to get some output. In such type of circumstances, fuzzy logic can be used, and it can be used very easily, and very relatable answers can be developed. It was first conceived and introduced by Professor Lofty Ajade in 1965. Means about 50 years back it was introduced, and nowadays it is used as one of the most well-known soft computing technique. Fuzzy logic provides stipulated truth value with closed intervals, means 0 to 1. 0 means false value, means it is not applicable, and 1 means the true value. So anything which may occur between it, it is known as what we can say is a particular value, then it is known as the fuzzy. So it is one type of soft computing technique, and computing uses softwares or computers for formulating a model, developing a model, and it is being solved. So here we can see, we can understand that some problems are there in the form of input is introduced, then soft computing technique is used, analysis is done, and the output has been produced. So here we are going to use fuzzy logic as a soft computing technique in which inputs will be entered and output will be get. So first of all, we need to understand what is meant by fuzzy logic in general. So if mathematically we see, we have studied about Boolean logic or the mathematical logic, which is also known as crisp logic, or rigidness is there. Means, is it called? So you are answering yes or no. Means you are answering either true or false, 0 or 1. So that is actually Boolean logic. Means you are giving only one answer, the perfect answer, the rigidness is there. But is it cold? If you are answering very much cold, little cold, or very less cold, in such a way so that if a person is who is receiving your answer is able to understand that very much means okay, not 100%, it is about 80-90%, or little means yes, of course there is some coldness, but yes, it is very less, 20-25% only. And very less means yes, it is about 10% only. So that is actually fuzzy logic. When a person is speaking in what we can say is words, and those words are being taken by the recipient as well. The person who is receiving the words is also able to understand that particular thing, what he want to say in that particular range between 0 to 1. So that is the beauty of the fuzzy logic. Here three words are written: crisp, probability, and fuzzy, which is written in comparatively larger. And above there are three terms written, that is continuous, discrete, and linear or non-linear. So continuous and discrete. Continuous means we are having continuous data of anything. For example, we are having continuous data of a particular person who is coming in a construction field. Discrete means we are having the data where we are having some values, then we are not having any values. So that thing is there. And linear and non-linear, that we always know. That if there is a linear relation between the input and output that can be identified, it is known as the linear. Otherwise, it may be called as non-linear as well. Crisp means anything which is having a perfect value, particular value. Example of crisp is Boolean logic. When you are answering yes or no, anything is there or not, then you have to answer only 0 or 1. Then comes probability. Probability is actually the possibility of occurrence of a particular event, whether it will occur or not. It is like that. Then comes the fuzzy. Fuzzy means, as we have discussed earlier as well, fuzzy means there is some flexibility, there is some understanding that the answer can't be 0 or 1. It can be between 0 to 1. It may be 0, 0.2, 0.5, 0.8, 0.9 or 1. So that thing is there. The fuzzy and probability are different things. Probability means possibility of occurrence of an event, whereas fuzzy is some flexibility in a particular answer, whether the answer may be between 0 to 1. So don't misunderstand between these two terms, probability and fuzzy. Now the introduction to the fuzzy logic. So fuzzy logic, as we know that the traditional methods which are used for modeling, mathematical framing, reasoning, computing, these are crisp and deterministic and precise in the nature. By crisp, we means the dichotomous, which means yes or no, which means 0 or 1, like that. So in the conventional dual logic, a statement can be true or false, nothing between that. So the speculation or understanding of anything between them cannot be done in the traditional tools and methods. So that thing is being incorporated in what we can say is fuzzy logic. Here some definitions are being written: crispness, vagueness, precision, and uncertainty. Crispness means firmness, some rigidness is there in a particular value. Vagueness means if the objects are there in which one cannot say with certainty. Means some lies may be there, or some discrete values may be there, or one cannot say a particular thing with a strength at that time, which is known as the vagueness, in which the things are unclear as well. Precision means the reproducibility or repeatability. It's the degree to which repeated measurements under unchanged conditions show some results. And uncertainty, that we always know. Anything which is uncertain means how many people are coming in the construction, how many laborers are coming, whether it will be rainfall or not in the in a particular monsoon day. So all these are uncertain things of which we cannot say anything. So those things can be called as an uncertain. Then comes the causes of uncertainty. What do we understand by uncertainty? What are those causes? So first is the lack of information. When we don't have any information, the information is very less. Or abundant information, complexity is there, we are not able to understand properly. Then conflicting evidences, many evidences are there, many proofs are there, but we are actually having some conflict between those. Then ambiguity, or we can say is the vagueness is there, measurements are there which are taken precisely or not, and belief, whatever we are going to believe, that is the thing which we know. Then type of the available information. So there are three things as far as the numerical methods are concerned, as far as even civil engineering is concerned, practical field is concerned, the three type of informations usually we have. First is numerical information. For example, number of people, number of staff, number of laborers. So that thing is there. Then interval based information, the second. So interval means how much interval we have to work, how much what we can say the particular thing or quantity we are having for the construction today. So it is like that. And third is the in linguistic information, symbolic information. What do we understand by linguistic? Linguistic means when the words are being used as symbolic information. So that is known as the linguistic. So set, as we all know, it may be defined as the collection of elements, collection of numbers or group in which some elements or values are there. That is known as the set. And fuzzy set means the fuzzy values are there. Crisp set means some particular values are there like that. So this is the example. You can see, say, age is there, say, a particular set is there, which the name of the set is A. Then example of the interval x, y, the values being there which can be plotted on the graph, it is like that. So fuzzy set is the collection of element in which every elements belong to that particular group or class up to certain degree or percentage. Degree is referred between 0 to 1, and if it is expressed in percentage, then also we can convert it into the degree by dividing it by 100. For example, if a person is there and who is called as experienced professional, he is having age of 35, and we are calling that he is having 100% experience, because at the age of 35 he is having 12, he or she is having experience of 12 to 14 years of field in the field of civil engineering. So we can call as an experienced professional. So he is having 100% belongingness or 100% membership to the perfectness as far as experience is concerned. So we can refer as the in per terms of percentage as 100% or in terms of degree as 1. But for example, if a person is having his age as 30, so he is also experienced, but up to certain, as compared to the age of 35, he is having a certain less experience. For example, he is having 80%, then the as compared to 35-year-old person. So he can be referred to as 80% belong to that particular set. Means 0.8 is the degree. If there is a person who is having, he is having the experience of 26 years, means 4 to 6 years of experience is there, then he or she may have 60% experience as compared to 35-year person. So the belongingness of a experienced professional group is 0.6, that is 60%. By the help of this, what we can say is the diagram, you will be able to understand the difference between the crisp and fuzzy. Crisp means either 0 or 1. You have to say yes or no. Is the person experienced? You will say yes or you will say no. And in terms of fuzzy set, it defines the value 0 to 1. Here you can see on the x-axis there is age from 0 to 90, and on the y-axis there are only two terms, that is 0 at the bottom and 1 at the top. So in such a way you can see here it is 0 and here it is 1. So this is the range between 0 to 1 where you have to classify it. Then fuzzy logic, that we have understood that it is based on the fuzzy sets in which certain membership or belongingness of a particular element is considered. Whether it belongs to 0%, 100%, 50%, 80% or something like that. The concept was first conceived and introduced by Lofty Jade, the professor at the University of California at Berkeley. So he presented it as not only controlled methodology but also way of processing the data. So now we will try to understand about the fuzzy sets and membership functions. This thing we have already understood. So fuzzy set theory and the fuzzy logic. So fuzzy set, how it is being written. So the range is very much important and how it is being used. Uncertainty, information and precision, these all are related in the fuzzy logic as well, because the information may be accurate, may be precise, may be ambiguity in the language may be there, so it is like that. So for understanding the fuzzy set, first we need to understand a crisp set. So this is actually a crisp set. Here you can see this particular set, 2, 3, 4, 5 are the elements of this particular set. It is there. Means anything, for example, if I am saying 6, so 6 is not there, so we will directly say no, it does not belong to that particular set. But 5, yes, it is there, it belongs to the set. So if we talk about crisp logic or Boolean logic, then we will have to say, is 5 a member of set? Then you will say yes, 100%. But is 6 a member of this set? No, 0%. So if it is expressed as yes or no, then it is a crisp. But if we are going to express in percentages, or we are giving some degree or membership to that particular value, then it is to be called as fuzzy set. So it is a collection of element that belongs to a group up to certain degree. So here is the example of a particular cricket player, Virendra Sehwag, has been given. So we are saying he is a good player up to 80%, 200% as per the average performance and behavior, and as far as his opening batting style is being concerned. So we will say he is 0.8, up to 0.8 degree he is a good player, or up to 1 degree. He is a good player. So in such a way we are going to express this. Crisp set means expressing it as 0 or 1. Probability means the possibility of occurrence of a particular thing. Optimization methods, as we have discussed in the previous module, getting the maximum benefits from the minimum efforts being put up by a particular person is the optimization, and the method used for getting the optimum or nearly best results is known as optimization method. Then fuzzy interpretation is there. When we are expressing something in words, something in understanding language, symbolic language, the words are being used, so that is there. And fuzzy logic is many valued probabilistic logic in which we are going to settle down the things about to solve. So this is actually the crisp set. If a particular number belong to that group, we will say yes, it belong to that group. But if we are not saying, if a number is not there, for example 8 is not in that this particular set, so we will say no, it is not a particular belonging to that group. So that thing we need to understand. Now fuzzy set. So fuzzy set is collection of elements belong to a set to a particular degree of truth or justification. And fuzzy sets, it is in a type in which an element belongs to a certain degree, means in between 0 to 100% or 0 to 1. By the help of one more example, we are going to discuss and understand it. That if example is having 180 centimeters or 6 feet height, if a person is 6 feet tall, so if he is having height less than 180 centimeter or more than that, so he will not be referred to as tall. You will say yes, of course. Which type of logic that he will not be referred to as tall? Yes, of course it will be referred. So if we are understanding with the help of this particular thing that, so for example, if a person is having as a height of 170 or he is having a height of 190, so 180 is yes 100% belonging to that group, but others are also belonging at some degree, for example maybe 0.6 or 0.8, like that. So we are not answering as yes or no, we are entering into partial truth. Partial truth means anything which is not 100% correct, but of course it is not 100% wrong, and it is having the value between 0 to 1. So that is actually the concept of partial truth. Then what do we understand by membership function? For example, we have seen that if a person is having this much height and he is belonging to this, so on the y-axis it is intersecting as 0.6. So where it is intersecting means how much degree it is justifying in percentage or in degree. So for example, if a height is 0.170 centimeter belonging to the 60% truth, so 0.6 is the degree, and this particular function which is being represented is known as the membership function. So any value, whether 165 centimeter, 170, 180, 185, 190 or 200 as the height is concerned, it will be having a particular degree of belongingness ranging between 0 to 1. Then these are the various types of membership functions. So this is the CRISP, means 100% value, only one value is given. This is triangle, increasing and then decreasing. It is trapezoidal, increasing, sustaining a particular value, then decreasing. And this is the Gaussian type, means increasing and decreasing in some different pattern. So that thing is near. So these are the type of membership function. One more example we are taking, that is of the fuzzy program. For example, if a strength of a class is there, and you are classifying that a particular class will be called as small if in that particular class the strength is between 0 to 30. At the same time, a particular person is saying no, the medium class will be from 10 to 80. And at the same time, a particular person is saying the large class will be greater than 50. So these are the three things that you have understood as far as the data collection is concerned. So here you can see there is some overlapping between small and medium, and there is also some overlapping between the medium and large. So that overlapping, you can understand here the overlapping is there, and here also the overlapping is there. So that is actually not the problem, but it is actually the beauty of fuzzy logic. It is the advantage of fuzzy logic that it also takes care of a particular thing belonging to that value as a small, and it also takes care of belongingness of a particular value in medium as well. So if you are having a confusion regarding anything, it may belong to any place. So this overlapping is there. If you are in the confusion, you can put that particular value in anywhere. So that thing is there. So that is what we understand as a fuzzy logic. So many type of membership functions are being used. And widely commonly used membership function is either the trapezoidal or the triangular membership function, because those represent the linear functionalities of a particular input or output variable. Then these are the operations. As you all know, what do you understand by CRISP or conventional sets? These are the properties, intersections, unions, thus you have been understood. So fuzziness, we have understood that anything which may belong to the 0 or 100%. So it may be referred to as a fuzzy set in general. means it may belong up to certain degree. So that degree, how much degree? So 0.2 means 20% it is belonging. So it is like that. So this is the fuzzy set theory. Even before when Professor Lofty Ajade has introduced in 1965, earlier also some development was going on by George Cantor in the fuzzy logic as well. So we can use the terms such as small, large, approximately equal, means partial truth based words can be used. So how it is being written? It is written in such a way. How it is written? It is written as x, mu x. X means a particular value. For example, a particular value is there. So this is a particular value. So we are going to understand this is the value 10 and 0.4 is its belongingness. 20 is a value and this 0.8 is its particular belongingness. So in such a way you can understood. So for example, if the cold ideal temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, so for less than it the degree of the degree will vary, and here 0.6, 0.4, and if the temperature greater than 25 is occurring, so also the degree will be green. So it is increasing and then it is decreasing. It is like that. So we need to understand it as well. Then these are the operations. The basic are the two operations, union and intersection, that you need to understand. So by, with the help of this figure, you can understand A union B. For example, one set is there A and one set is there B. So A set is 1, 2, 3, 4. The B set is 3, 4, 5, 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 3, 4, 5, 6. If you will get the union, you will get all the values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It is simple, basic and mathematics. So that is there. Union is known as the maximum operator and intersection is known as the minimum. Means whatever B is common. For example, if we are finding out the A intersection B, we will get the value as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So intersection value will be 3 and 4 only. It is like that. So if we are having a particular set as 3, 0.6, 3, 0.5, and we are finding maximum, we will take the greater value of belongingness, that is 0.6. So here for in this example, we have selected the 0.6. But if we are going for the intersection, we will select the lesser value. In such a way, we used to understand. So in such a way, the union and intersections has been taken place and it works. So what do we understand by the alpha cut and strong alpha cut? Alpha cut means if you want to take a particular set above a particular degree. For example, you want to consider anything above the belongingness of 0.4. So if you are taking all the values of set, only those having the belongingness or degree of membership more than 0.4, those are referred as alpha cut sets. And if you are considering even neglecting the value of 0.4 belongingness and you are considering only above 0.4, that is known as strong alpha cut set. So that you can understand. So these are the values, different values that you can understand. So even if you are having the value greater than that, if you are considering it is a strong alpha cut, but if that particular degree, for example 0.3, you are considering, so that is the alpha cut. So this is the strong alpha cut, you can see. And if it is 0.5, then only values having greater than 0.5 belongingness will be considered. So these are the normal fuzzy sets and subnormal fuzzy sets, you can see with the help of diagrams. These are the convex, means the value is increasing and decreasing. Non-convex, it is having some different patterns, and the intersection is there. Here you are, you will be able to see what we can say, some intersection over here. Means if you are not sure that in which particular set you are going to put, that you can check with yourself. Now the fuzzy relations are being there. Which type of fuzzy relations you can see? So if, for example, you are having two plans, plan A is better than plan B, the water quality and temperature is good for swimming. So these are the sets, these are the if then else statements. that you can prepare in the fuzzy logic. For example, if there will be more rainfall, then there will be more infiltration. If there will be less rainfall, there will be less runoff. So like that, if else rules can be created, and if else rules are known as the fuzzy rules, in which you are putting some conditions. And here we are, I am giving simple examples, but in complex problem these examples are going to help you very much. Now we will try to understand the term variables. If we are having this equation x plus y equal to 5 and x plus 2y equal to 7, when we will solve, we will get the particular values. Means for a variable x, y, z, p, q, r, we will always use to get some values. These are known as the variables which have particular value. But what happens whenever a particular word, a particular statement has taken as a variable, it is known as linguistic variable or linguistic value. For example, I am asking that what is the age of a person, in which category you want to put. So instead of saying, for example, a person is having age of 30 and you are saying no, he is young or he is old or he is experienced, like that. So you are using words at that time. For example, you are using such type of words, young, very young, not very young, old, more or less old, and categorizing in between 0 to 100 as a category. But you are using word, so that particular word is known as linguistic variable. Now we will try to understand the fuzzy logic as a concept of input and output model, how it is being used. What are the fuzzy rules, propositions, implications and inferences that we will use? So application and model formulation with the fuzzy rules will be there. These are the basic four components to apply the fuzzy logic. First is fuzzification of the data. Means whatever be you are having the things, you will categorize those values. Those inputs will be categorized. For example, you are having rainfall and how much runoff will occur. Means after rainfall, how much water will flow in a particular city. For that, you are preparing a model. Means input will be rainfall and output will be runoff, and you are using fuzzy logic. So first thing is you will categorize rainfall into fuzzification. You will do fuzzification, means you will prepare a range. For example, rainfall will be there, so you will categorize rainfall in 3 or 5 terms, means less rainfall, medium rainfall and high rainfall. And similarly, you will categorize runoff as well. You have to categorize output as well. For example, less runoff, medium runoff and high runoff. And then you will have to prepare the statements. If rainfall is less, runoff will be less. In such a way, you have to categorize. So that is the fuzzification you have to do, and you have to prepare the fuzzy rules. Then you have to do the program evaluation. The particular model in the MATLAB you can prepare. I will show you the steps. And then defuzzification will be done. Whatever be the fuzzy rules you have given, you have entered a value of rainfall. After preparing the model, you will give a value as input. For example, you have entered 60 centimeters. So after occurring 60 centimeter of rainfall, how much runoff will be occur? A particular value will be given as the answer. A particular word will not be given, that you will enter 60 centimeter runoff, rainfall, 60 centimeter rainfall, and runoff will be given as a word, that less runoff. No, a particular value of runoff will be given. So that process of converting the values after the process of model into a particular value is known as the defuzzification. So that is one type of method. So these are the fuzzy rules, in which if then else rules are created. If more than one inputs are there, then you can prepare the model as if and then model you can prepare. If you are having number of inputs as a method. So in the fuzzy logic methodology, input, fuzzy rules and output, these are the three things. Input will be there, output will be there, and you have to prepare the fuzzy rules. And then you have to correlate that particular values. So this is the input. For example, a particular model is there, input is 1 temperature only and output is AC control. So temperature you have to categorize it in a value, and output that will be categorized is less air, cool air, high cool air and very high cool air, in such a way. So depending upon the temperature you will get the output. So this membership function, for example 10, if temperature is near about 10, less cool air, 20 also less cool air, 30 cool air, then temperature is 40, means temperature is high, so you will demand very cool air. Then temperature is 50, you will demand very high cool air, in such a way. And you can prepare the rules as well. So that particular rule you can prepare. So this is the fuzzification that you will do, then you will go for rules, and then defuzzification will have to be there. Then this is one of the model, one case study which I have been taken, in which the temperature and soil moisture degree is giving you the irrigation duration. Here they have used 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 membership function. Here 3, 1, 2 and 3 membership functions are used. Here also 3 membership functions are being used. Means temperature and soil moisture degree will give you the result as the irrigation duration, in such a way. And in such a way, if and then rules are prepared. If and then rules are being prepared. What is the condition of temperature? What is the conditions? Then it will be used. So here you can see that a particular statement will give you particular answer. So for only one condition, you will have to choose one answer. If this is one condition, you will have to choose only one answer. For one condition, for one input condition, only one answer will be chosen. So that we need to remember. So in the LabVIEW software, the screen will be appearing like this. So many applications of the fuzzy logic are there. As I have told you earlier, that fuzzification will be there. You have to convert the data sets into a range, and in as per that range you have to prepare the rules, if and then rules. You have to prepare if else rules. Then decision making will be done by itself, by the model itself, by the MATLAB, and then defuzzification will be appear and you will get your answer. These are the, for example, in such a way, this is the screen, this is the input, this is the medium and this is the high. So here you are having what we can say is the overlapping. The overlapping, as per the research papers, 20-30% overlapping is allowed, but in special cases up to 60-70% overlapping is also allowed. This is the if else rules. For here you can see the rainfall is given, here the runoff is given. So if it is less, then this is less. If this is medium, this is medium. If this is high, this is high. In such a way you can categorize the answers. But remember, for one input condition you will have to get only one output answer. So in such a way, wherever your condition will be lie, as per the rules it will get particular answer. Here you can see the red line, this red line. So in that particular red line which is being showing, it will give you a particular value, and that is your answer. Defuzzification is actually interpreting, means producing a particular quantifiable results as a fuzzy set. So it gives a crisp value as a product. So whatever you are going get, you are able to see here that a particular trapezoidal is there, but it will defuzzify it. A particular value will be obtained in this after solving it. So that method is known as defuzzification. Number of methods, centroid method, maximum membership, weighted average, different values are being given. So among the different value, it can be set, it can be decided. So in such a way, for example, this is the defuzzification MATLAB. In MATLAB we use the centroid method, it is the most commonly used method. In such a way it works, you can see that how that particular value is being defined. It is actually calculated by software itself, we don't need to do anything. So this is actually the input and you will get the output. So this is actually the cycle, this is actually the method, in such a way we are working. From input, fuzzification unit, decision will be made and output we will get. With the help of this system, you will be able to know. Now applications are there, many applications are there, conventional methods, patent recognition, it saves time, gives more efficient results, direct results will be given. Even if you are having less data or not having any data, you can find the results. Day-to-day applications means automatic car controls are having this. By remote you can control the cars. Automatic foxing in the cameras, refrigerator, air conditioning, many things they are having the day-to-day results. These are the many applications: rainfall runoff forecasting, structural material suitability, reservoir operation, stream flow prediction, many in the transportation, traffic is there, trip generation, model split, urban growth, transportation infrastructure system. In many field, fuzzy logic is having its applications. Now the tutorial or experiment and how it works, or one input, one output model, or two output model that you can define. For example, you have to prepare rainfall runoff model, how step-by-step procedure in the MATLAB has been depicted. So you can refer where you have to go, you have to type fuzzy in the MATLAB. This type of dialog box will be open. In such a way you can prepare such type of step-by-step procedure is being given. That will be explained to you in the lab time. So that thing is there. This is the method how you will get a particular output. And the speed acceleration example is also given. In such a way these rules will be prepared, and based on this you will get a particular answer. Suppose this is the answer that you will get. So that is there. In water quality measurement it is also having application. You will have some input, you will have some output, and you will try to force. So now you can give the answer of this review question: what is fuzzy logic, what is difference between Boolean or crisp and fuzzy logic, what is fuzzy set and membership function. You can describe the operations on fuzzy sets, you can describe fuzzy relations, you can define what do you understand by fuzzy rules, its uses. You can analyze different defuzzification techniques, you can describe applications of fuzzy logic in the field of civil engineering or day-to-day applications, and the model preparation using the fuzzy or formulation of the model that will be done, and in the practical sessions as well, and the step-by-step procedure of developing a model in the MATLAB is being given. So don't worry about that. These are few references and links that you can go through it, so it will be useful for you all. And these are important links of the YouTube and other references. So thank you very much for keeping yourself in this video. Keep yourself at home, stay at home, stay safe. This is the only way to fight with COVID-19 corona. So thank you very much once again for being in the lecture.